right, everybody, good morning. Let's do a little bit of a walk and talk. So it's been basically 2 years, literally to the date, since we had a trip to New York City. So the last trip, obviously, as everybody knows, was during COVID. Now the city's basically in the full swing of things. So let's go figure out what we're gonna do today. For this part of the video, by the way, I decided to stop down at Battery Park, which is gonna be in the southwest corner of Manhattan Island. This is basically where you would take the Statue of Liberty cruise tours. You can take the Staten Island Ferry. Came down here with the first intention to try and figure out if I could somehow make my way onto the Statue of Liberty ferry. It was sold out for the entire week. There it goes as we speak. Normally the weather is not this fantastic early April. To put it into perspective, normally I come here, I've got a jacket, jeans and whatnot. I'm in shorts, it's gonna get up to 80 today. It is some of the most beautiful weather I've had in all my times here coming early in the spring. So, with not being able to do the Statue of Liberty, I'm gonna knock another item off my list. So let's go head over to the Brooklyn Bridge. I wanna walk that, get some shots of Manhattan Island from the other side of Brooklyn, and then we'll see where we go from there and see what our time looks like. So we left Battery Park, took the 5 train uptown to City Hall, Brooklyn Bridge, and we're gonna walk the Brooklyn Bridge for literally the first time for me. Just know you've got a jaunt. This is normally a bridge to access Brooklyn for cars, right? All right, here we go. We're at the actual entrance of the bridge. You can tell because the decking changes to this wooden kind of like almost boardwalk material. Well, let's go walk and take a look. So I tell you this, guys, and I mean it, you know, been here many times, enjoyed this city in a lot of different ways. I've been touristy, I've been, you know, live like a local, stayed here for quite a long time, several times, you know. I've never done this, and that's a regret up until now. Make it to the first tower, by the way, just one, you're like a third in, maybe, probably not even that, but the cool part is you're greeted with views like this. Past the first tower a little bit, you're gonna not see the suspension cables, which makes sense because they basically go down to meet the bottom of the road deck at one point. What I'll tell you though is your view is absolutely rewarded. Let's take a look left and right, and we'll show you some things.
Cash fools everything around me. Cream, get the money. Dollar, dollar bill, yo. Cash fools everything around me. Cream, get the money. Dollar, dollar bill, yo.
So one thing I wanted to go over in this trip too, just to help some people out. So for the New York subway, I'm a huge advocate of using the subway for your trip. It just makes the most sense. You're gonna get the most economical trip, basically, because all of your travel, basically you get to the city and then you pay basically a flat rate and there you go. But that's kind of changed a little bit with this recent system. So in the past, you would always use your handy Metro card, but they've invested in a new system called Omni, which basically uses RFID readers to either work with RFID cards or cell phones. So in the future, really, you just actually need your cell phone to go ahead and use the subway. What you do is you go to a website called OMNY, and what you do is you tie your credit card to it, and then you put that credit card on your cell phone. From there, you just tap your cell phone to it, it charges the payment, and you go through. Now, I know some people are probably gonna start saying, oh, well, I don't wanna be charged for a trip, it makes more sense for a 7-day. If you use more than 12 trips, it's an unlimited for that entire week, Monday through Sunday. If you don't use it, you only get charged what you do need to use, which is great because it's still less than a traditional MetroCard 7-day with buy a big car. So in the future, set up Omni, OMNY. Make sure you get that configured before you come here. Tie it to your phone. It's a great investment. It's what you need to use for everything. So obviously we're back in Grand Central Terminal. Last trip, I kind of did this as just a quick, let me run through real quick before I had a plane to catch. Now I got a little bit of time, I can deep dive in it. And two, they also finished some of the restoration work, so I'll show you what you couldn't see before. With a little movie making magic, left Grand Central Terminal, finished up there, did lunch in the area and whatnot. I have to remember that the last time I was here was literally right in the height of COVID, right? So coming through here was kind of quiet, you were on your own, You know, it really felt like you could just enjoy everything intimately. Right now, it actually looks like this. So here we are at the Bethesda Terrace, which is way more crowded than it ever has been, but it's kind of cool. There's actually a concert going on behind me. I'll try to grab a video of it on my way out. But one thing I wanted to talk about, now that I just realized coming into Central Park. So my original plans were to actually have lunch over in the Loeb Boathouse. And I didn't know about it until I started looking into planning everything, but they're closed. They did not recover after COVID. And it was getting more difficult for them, so in 2022, they shut down. One thing to know about New York, and this is kind of the thing, is obviously there are staples, there are things that will be here till the end of time, right? Central Park, Empire State Building, Statue of Liberty, so on, right? But everything else can change. Don't build habits here. You know, there are certain things, sure, absolutely hit up some things that really make you happy and that you're favorites, but just know, this city never sleeps, and this city will always move forward. Cash moves everything around me. Cream.